Woof. So there's another still. I'm gonna rest up. I got to use one extra hailstorm than I otherwise wouldn't have been. And I ended up with a beam of fire at the end, all the way to the very end. He's out of rocks. I have some rocks. I don't think he can carry them all. Tragic, that is. Nope. He can't even carry 25 rocks. Ten rocks? I probably have too much gold. Take 300 gold. I'm gonna end up dropping this gold. Hey, you couldn't. Did I try to give all the gold? I should just try that in the first place. Okay, he can carry some stuff now. I can also. How many rations do you think it would take to get him up to full? Take his rations too. Now let's see how many racks he can carry. Can you take all of them? Yes. Sweet. You can take more as well. Not another 20 more. How about 10? Yeah, I'm satisfied now. Now, Silk is completely out of arrows. So give him the Assassin's Blade. We can't. You can take it, okay. I have to move something. Okay, probably don't even need this villa key. Here, you take it. Okay, he's got Assassin's Blade, which is spelled wrong, I think. It's supposed to be A-S-S-A-S-S-I-N-S, or missing an S. So maybe I can have him slip in next to an enemy, not right in front, and have him start attacking with the Assassin's Blade, so he can dart around like that. That'll make for something interesting. And anything else, just sleeping. Who's got 5? Oh, he's got 99 and 5. Okay. I was like, what happened to the rest of his rocks? I didn't realize there was another stack. Okay. So I'm going to tackle that other one, but we want rest. So I'll speed that up. Alright, sleep done. Checking the charges on this. 15, oh boy. Then we're gonna have to start using her spells to do it, which is okay. She has light 2. Does this cast light 2 or light 3? Light 3, Well, it's good for these outdoor areas. I think as far as the dungeons, light 2 is... works the same, it just doesn't last as long. So I'm gonna save and take on this thing. Or things. Hope the castle isn't too much further. I forgot to move him over. I wanted to have him more like moved over. I thought I was recording. I had Silk run in and start attacking this thing with the assassin's blade. But the thing started attacking him because it was attacking Griban, but I guess he got his attention because Griban is not attacking it. He's attacking this one along with everybody else, and he's throwing hailstorm and now ice balls. So I'm going to back him off. I prefer to show it rather than telling, but I thought I was recording and I am not. So I'm going to heal Drobaneer. And yeah, that's it. Join you back at the moment of anything interesting. Okay. I'm gonna try this again. Now I've got Drobaneer in front. It is attacking Drobaneer, at least last round it did, so I'm gonna move Silk in, see if we can have 3 against 1. Guess we might finish killing the thing by then, but I don't know. Just curious if it'll keep attacking Drobaneer once. It should. Again, for a lot, too. Drobaneer not hitting for very much. Heal him? Sure. Well, have Silk attack now. So now we'll have 3 against 1. Casting a spell. So does it forfeited its round, in effect. He should be fine now. Yeah, pretty good, okay. He didn't do much damage, but it's cool having 3 against 1, I like it. Because I can't stand these octopus things. They're like, I can't say bullet sponges, but I guess sword sponges and spell sponges. complete until, you know, repeat until dead, basically. It's too bad Silk doesn't have some kind of, like, backstab ability or something. I don't know how that would really work. I mean, maybe if we did put invisibility. Yeah, it did. Sweet. If we use invisibility, maybe that would be an option. I am saving. Okay, that's a dead end there. That tree looks different than the others. Oh, nothing. Is this a separate marsh? Yeah, it's a separate marsh. We came from up here, right? Yeah, we came from one up there. Dead end. We should rest. We should go over here and rest. I am going to rest and we'll continue on our way because Trasric has no mana at all. So we're gonna, yeah, do our thing. Okay, Satine, get our protections up. Thank you. I'm in trouble just getting to this dungeon. Alright, so that was a dead end up here. We go south. Said southwest. Okay, I wonder what's this way though. I know this is east, but maybe just dead end. Never know, there might be treasure. No. Alright, we go this way. Try to go around this thing. Oh, what am I attacking? Spiders? Alright. We'll do spiders. Oh, I forgot I got these guys crunched over here. I have to change the formation back to what it was. And I think I'll swap these two. I'm just gonna leave him there. Ice balls. Yeah. One down. I hope we don't come across any more of those, not even one more octopus, because things are so tough. They give a good experience, but I'm kind of tired of it right now. That makes any sense? Silk's just gonna hang out. He's out of arrows. If he jumps up and starts hitting melee, then he's gonna get attacked, and I don't feel like healing him. So Sorry, Silk. Okay. Guess we'll do this. Oh no, one hit point. We're doomed. Remember when we started out, we had like 4 hit points because we didn't have a character level? That was crazy. Come on. Yeah, Joe Bonier. Take him out. So we get 30. What do we get for the octopus? 50? I'd rather fight a lot of these spiders than fight those things. Which way was I heading? Let's change our... Was I going south? Or was I headed this way? I think I was headed this way. Was I? God damn, I can't remember. That's the problem. I get in these battles, and then once the battle's done, I've forgotten which way I was going. Hate that. It kind of looks like grass up there, but no, we can't fit through. Oh, we got blasted. Only 2 of us, though. Oh no, not healing. No. Dead end. Somehow we avoided that. Is this where we came from? No, because there's a friend here to greet us. Oh, there's more spiders up there. Damn. We're both down 1 point. Perfect. Try to sneak him up on the side, see how that works. Oh! Good job in here for 24. Move him up, Attacking Gribban. Jobinir probably won't make it in time, but that's okay. Took that a little damage. Makes it a little more interesting, I guess. Is this the approach? I guess I'm gonna start speeding this up. It's just spiders over and over again. Boop, boop, boop. More spider ore. Oh, that's right. He had illness that I was gonna cure on him, and the battle ended before I got a chance to do it. It cast a spell, so I'll get rid of that now. And I'll be speeding up the battle once again. This is a new thing. I got irritated. Let's see if I can move him up here. Oh, I can't cast any spells because I'm irritated. Jeez, you imagine that in real life? That'd be like every day something irritates you, right? In this world? Maybe? I don't know. What do we have that removes irritation? Crap. It doesn't sound familiar to me either. Not rejuvenate, right? Paralysis, poison. Oh my god. What removes? Oh my god, is she stuck? This would be really bad. Mind? Question mark. What would remove irritation? That's horrible. I mean, if I can't find something that removes that. I think it would be an herb, right? Stun, poison, madness? Blue plant? It doesn't say she went mad. It says she's irritated. Let's finish this battle, if we can actually hit anything. What does rejuvenation do? Man, I don't want to have to do all this over, can you imagine? I mean, I do have spell slots. I mean, I have save slots that I can just go to right before I went through all this, but I don't want to have to do that. Unless I use the teleport to teleport back to Sanctuary's Island and then go from there. But still, I'd still have to come back all the way through this. You know, if you die once, what's his name saves you. So if I let something kill us, that's a way to get back, right? Without having to fight all this stuff over again. We'd have to traverse the land over again. Yeah, hopefully that's not necessary. We'll have to weigh our options. Alright, kill these stupid things, will ya? I'm irritated in real life now. You can start hitting it. Maybe rejuvenate? I'm not sure what rejuvenate does. Hopefully there's no more spiders coming up on us while we try to figure out what to do. Oh, it's attacking Silk. I only hit him for 1 point, though. See if we can get rid of my irritation. Okay. It's gone. It's gone. It just lasts the battle. Alright. I'm hoping anyway. Saving in a new slot. Anybody need healing? Now that I can heal? Jobinir, I guess we can top him off. Now I'll save. Oh! I guess this is it. You are standing before a huge pile of bones. As you try to turn away from the terrible sight, you see a window open above the entrance. Shortly afterwards, a skeleton slides loudly, clattering out of the opening and crashes onto the pile of bones. The window closes again just as the last few bones clatter to the ground. Alright, we got bones. They're removing the heads? Or... I don't know. Let's see if there's anything about these trees. They look interesting, but there are trees like this on the, above ground as well. What if I try to look at the castle? Is there any bones? No. With a loud bang, the door slams shut behind you. As you turn around, you find to your horror that where the door was is now just a bare wall. Ha 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 ha. Castle of Manyeye. This is a way to tell how wide... We can't really tell from that. Okay, I guess I'll leave it here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time when we brave the Castle of Manyeye. No way out of here, I guess, until we defeat the big baddie within and all the other baddies that lay before him or it or something. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, and always seek adventure.